Hello, welcome back to my session. Myself Azana. In today's session, we are going to discuss about image processing techniques. The ultimate goal of today's session will be what are all the steps to be done when we pass image as an input and what steps to be taken care before we pass it to a model. Let's start with what and why image processing. As a machine learning engineer, we will spend a good amount of time in cleaning up and preparing the data before we build a model. The goal of this step is to make our data ready for the machine learning model to make it easier to analyze and process computationally. Image processing could be simple tasks like image resizing, but to feed a data set of images to a convolutional network, images should be all of same size. Other processing techniques like geometry, color transformation, converting to grayscale and few more techniques will be discussed in today's session. Why image processing? As we are aware that the data will be collected from different sources, so the data will be too messy. To feed them into machine learning model or a neural network, they need to convert it into standardized and clean up. So the ultimate goal of pre-processing step is to reduce the complexity and to increase the accuracy of the model. In today's session, we are going to use image data generator than OpenCV. The reason is OpenCV perform operation and stores them in memory, which means it will require a lot of memory space. Indirectly, the computational cost will increase, whereas image data generator perform image processing during the process of model fitting, which means it requires less memory and is efficient for deep learning application. To do this, we have to pass tensorflow.keras.preprocessing.image with a class image data generator. We can achieve this activity by two methods. One is flow, the another one is flow from directory. We will understand which technique to use when. Flow is really helpful when we have a less amount of data. Here we need to pass input and label. Whereas flow from directory really helpful when we have a large amount of images. Here we have to pass images in different folder where each folder corresponds to a class. Now let's start with hands-on for the method flow. For this we have to pass an argument input data. It should be of NumPy of rank 4. Nothing but batches, image width, image height and channel, label, batch size, shuffle, sample weight and seed. For this we are going to use the famous data set nothing but CIFAR-10. It consists of 16,000 images of size 32 of 32. It's all color images. It contains 10 classes. Each class contains 6,000 images. It's split into training and test. It consists of 50,000 in training and 10,000 images in test data. Parallel, we will also check what will be the challenges when we pass image size of 32 of 32. To load the data, we have to pass tensorflow.keras.dataset import CIFAR-10. Then the necessary libraries and the important for today's session is the main class image data generator. To load the data, we have to pass CIFAR-10.load_data. To find the shape of the extract, we have to pass dot shape. It says that we have 50,000 images of size 32 of 32. The last one is nothing but a channel, means a color channel, RGB, nothing but red, green, blue. To understand this concept, I created one more video which is highlighted in this notebook as well as I will highlight in the description as well. Please refer to this video to get a clear concept of what and how this color is handled in terms of computer point of view. Now let's start displaying the images. Here I am passing a range between 0 to 9. So we will limit the images to 9 images. Let me increase the size of the image. Now we can see that the images are not clear. The reason is we are just passing the image size nothing but 32 of 32. So we will understand how to fix this issue. Next, I am passing image data generated to the local variable of data gen, and the next step is I am passing fit parameter. Here the method is flow. I am passing with the variable x train, y train, and the batch size is 9. So this is all about the method for flow. Now let's start understanding about flow from directory. This is useful when we have a large images. For this we have to pass an argument directory, target size, color mode, class is an optional, class mode, batch size, shuffle, and shader. For this I am going to use a data set of multi-class. It's a combination of car, cat, and dog. Let me show you the data set. In car we have different images of size 650 488 300 225, and all are with different images. To load this data I am passing the method flow from directory. Then the directory, I just copy the part and I paste it here. The color mode is RGB. Here we can pass either a grayscale, RGB or RGBA. And the batch size is, it should be integer. I am passing with 32. The class mode is categorical. If it is binary, means a 2 class, means we have to pass a binary. If it is more than 2 class, in our case it's a 3 class, so I am passing a categorical. Shuffle equal to true. If I am not passing this command, the training will be in a sequential, means a first set will be car, followed up with cat, and followed up with dog. So this is not the proper way to train the model. So we have to shuffle the data by passing the command shuffle equal to true. Next, the seed, it should be integer. It should be of any number. I am passing 42, and the target size is 32 of 32, which means that here we have images of all different sizes. Now it will convert to the same size of 32 of 32. Let me execute this step. It found totally 27 images belonging to 3 classes. Now let's start accessing the properties of images. Here I am passing training underscore generator dot next to x batch of y batch. To find the shape, yes, we have to pass dot shape. So which is a 4 dimensional array. It says it contains 27 images, 32 of pixel width, 32 of pixel height, 3 is a color channel. To find the shape of y batch, passing y batch dot shape. And then here I am restricted to 5 index, which is like a one-hot encoder. And then I am displaying x batch of 1 index, means passing the first index of 0. So it displayed with 32 of 32 of 3. Now we will display the image. Now we found that images are not clear. We cannot able to differentiate. We can find that it's a kind of car something, but to the system point of view, these images are not clear. The reason is we just pass the size of 32 of 32. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the target size from 32 to 100, which means I'm converting images of all different size to a target size of 100 of 100. Again, I am re-executing the relevant step. Now we can see that the images are quite clear, which is good for the system to understand. But we want to make sure, and the point to highlight here is whenever we passing the image size with a small pixel, it will be easy to calculate. When we pass a large images, means it will take a lot of time, but we should not compromise with the quality of the picture. So this is also one of the hyperparameter to choose the right size of the image. Now we will go with data pre-processing. The first step is converting our color images to grayscale images. In most of the use cases, color will be just noise. So in such cases, we have to convert the color images to grayscale images. But in certain cases like skin cancer detection, color play an important role. In such cases, we should not convert a color images to grayscale images. So to do this action, we have to pass a parameter color mode equal to grayscale. Let me execute this step. So now all color images are converted into grayscale images. The next step is rescaling an image. So here I am converting range from initially all the images with the range 0 to 255. Now we are converting the pixel value to 0 to 1. For this I am passing image data generator with the parameter rescale is equal to 1 by 225. So once we done with this step, all images are between 0 to 1 instead of 0 to 255. Images still look same as original. Point to highlight here is it will not change the content of the image. The next one is feature wise standardization. To do this, we have to pass two arguments. One is feature wise underscore center equal to true, and the other one is feature wise underscore STD underscore normalization, which is equal to true. But the point to highlight here is it will change the content of the image. So in most of the use cases, we go for normalization than the standardization. Let me execute this step. Once we execute it, this will be the output. The next one is rotation of image. For this, we have to pass a parameter rotation underscore range is equal to 90. Here I am passing the value as 90. It may be any value. So now images are rotated to a position of 90 degree. The next one is shifting an image. Here we have two options. One is horizontal shift. The another one is vertical shift. To do this, we have to pass two arguments. One is width underscore shift underscore range. The another one is fill underscore mode. But make sure that we should apply this operation in the right term. For an example, we should not perform this operation in traffic signal. When we perform this operation in traffic signal, then the direction will be totally changed. So make sure that where to apply this parameter, there we have to pass this pre-processing technique. Same way, we have to pass this vertical shift. With this parameter, height underscore shift underscore range. Let me execute this step. The next one is flipping an image. To do this, we have to pass two arguments. One is horizontal flip and vertical flip. The next operation is zooming an image. To do this, we have to pass zoom underscore range and fill mode. It will be either zoom in or zoom out. This both operations can be performed in zooming an image. And the next one is sharing an image. For this, we have to pass an argument share underscore range. So these are all about the pre-processing techniques. And then the next important factor is data augmentation. For this, I created one more video which will be highlighted in description as well. So please go through this video to understand the concept of data augmentation. So this is all about the today's sessions. I hope the content is really useful. If you like the session, please subscribe, like and share. Catch you soon in the next session. Till then, Fazana signing off.